idea of public itself is a 19th century creation. So in the last decades of the 19th century, there was quite a furious discussion on whether women should be permitted to enter the public at all, especially among those who belong to the privileged sections of society at that time, to the elite. So you see, for example, the first women's magazine in Malayalam called Keraliya Suguna Bodhini, there was an editor's preface to start with, where there was this clear indication that they will publish nothing related to politics and religion. Isn't that interesting? I think women need to read some history, some, you know, edifying stories, poetry. They must be cultured, but they need not get into the public. Now, but remember, this is also the century when low-caste women were actually challenging the upper caste on the streets of Kerala. Newly converted women, low-caste women, Chanar women, were insisting on wearing the upper cloth. So wearing an upper cloth on your left shoulder was indicative of a higher caste state. Now, the point is, the missionaries who converted them just wanted to conform to Victorian morality. So they just wanted the women to wear blouses. And the Brahminical Travancore state had no problems at all. But they objected to these women wearing an upper cloth. This became a great matter of contention. The missionaries were very irritated by these women, because the missionaries couldn't figure out why they needed this upper cloth. Because the missionaries just believed that you need to make them modest Christians. Now, that should be done with a blouse. Why incite the upper caste? And these women apparently would just not listen. Women who went to the roads and the markets wearing the upper cloth got attacked by the Nair men, who tore off their upper garments and beat them up. So this is hardly sexual, it's far more casteist. Now these women just refused. They just kept on going. They would come back home, put on another upper cloth and go. So, there is this persistence that these women show. This was a continuous struggle between 1820s and 1860s and even afterwards. So at a time when our intellectuals were like debating whether educated women should be getting into public or not, lower caste women were already on the streets combating